design, we will cleanse you. You were adored, Minthara. Brought up from the darkness and into the Absolute's light.
She cherished you, but it wasn't enough. You were distracted by your own desires.
Bloodlust, murder, chaos.
And most damning of all, an inability to follow orders.
I obeyed to the best of my ability!
And isn't that depressing? You are nothing.
The drow reaches out to you psychically, connecting with you for a moment. She is infected like you. Her mind is disintegrating.
Come to observe, true soul. She is a lesson. None can rise so high that they cannot fall again. A challenge, sister. Who would be so bold?
Awful, sister. Meat that doesn't yet know it is dead.
Expected to be greeted as a hero. But the wretches imprisoned me and tried to tear my mind apart. I didn't think anyone would come for me. Agreed. Lead the way.
Let's have a look.
Enjoy the view. This feels like it'd stretch all the way to the Sea of Swords in a clear day.
I last left Moonrise, as a commander in the Absolute's army, obeying the voice of a god. I thought I had found a home and a purpose.
Now I leave as an exile. But you risked your life to rescue me. For that, I am grateful.
The artifact connects with her, pulling your minds together. And showing her all that you have seen. The prism, your dream visitor, the protection that keeps you from obeying the Absolute and becoming a Lithid. She knows it all in a moment. Her mind reels, but is no longer clouded. She accepts the truth. She has no choice.
There is much we must discuss. Do you have a safe place to camp nearby?
Goodbye for now. I will see you soon.
Keep me out.
What's that? does Wreathwind Ale ring a bell?
It's known to be quite the tipple. A cask or two still exists. If you know the right ale keep.
You must have good taste. Not me. Can't afford it.
Oh, a common misconception. Even the simplest of flavors are elevated by the choice to appreciate them. Don't deny yourself such pleasures.
It does not compare with the comforts of home, but your camp is almost palatial in comparison to my previous accommodation. Thank you for allowing me to come here and for bringing me back to myself. Each memory that returns to me is more disturbing than the last. The things that I did in the name of the Absolute. The things that were done to me. They broke my mind. While our tadpoles live, and the cult have the means to control them, we will never be safe. We must eradicate them. Starting with General Thorm. I mean Ketherick. My deference to him is a habit that will die hard, I fear. All that live can die. I can help you plot Ketherick's demise, but I need something from you first. Swear that you will keep me close. Until the Absolute is dead, at least. The Prism will protect me. You will fight alongside me and help me to get my vengeance. I knew you were different to other true souls when we met, but I could see nothing clearly. Now, thanks to the Prism, the Absolute does not cloud my thoughts at all. I see that together, we can have our vengeance on those who infected us. Rest well, and keep your wits about you. Tomorrow, we go to war with the cult of the Absolute. General Thorm would have the world believe that his invulnerability is a gift from the Absolute. That is a lie, intended to impress those who flock to the cult's cause, and to strike fear in the minds of those who stand against the Absolute. I believe Thorm draws his power not from a divine source, but an arcane one. I suspect it is the very relic that Balthazar has been sent to retrieve. We must find the necromancer and claim what he seeks, or destroy it. Now, rest. We will need our strength for what lies ahead. Excellent. Let us teach the cult to fear us.
Our enemies still draw breath.
at your command. If it is for the best, awaiting orders.
Time to rest.
Minthar is something of a closed book. But I suspect a heart of gold lurks beneath that stern countenance. Once she gets to know me, I'm sure she'll open up. She's just waiting for someone ready to listen. I question the wisdom of that decision, but so be it.
She expects those who seek to use the weave to do so honored.
I doubt she's asked many of her followers to blow themselves up. That's a fate she's bequeathed exclusively to me. She wouldn't ask such a thing if it weren't our only means of survival. However much she's annoyed at me. Go ahead. I'm listening. I question the wisdom of that decision, but so be it. I'll be here in the meantime, idling away the hours.
I want to be clear. Letting Minthara tag along with us was your idea. So if you wake up with a dagger to your throat, that's on you. Excuse me. I'm sorry for looking out for our collective hides. But fine. Take her if you wish. Just know I'll be resting with one eye open. Oh, darling, I'm hurt. I thought we had something special. I guess I'll spend my evenings lounging here while you do all the hard work. It sounds awful.
Hear me.
The Drow is unpredictable, uncompromising. I respect her almost as much as I distrust her.
Are you sure that's the best course of action? Confirmed. Until then, I remain at the ready.
You wish to consult me? I took up my oath long ago, when I swore bloody vengeance against any who defied Loth. Now, I myself have sinned against the Spider Queen. Though my faith is shattered, my oath endures. I am sworn to destroy all those who serve the Absolute. It is not noble, it is necessary. If we do not destroy the cultists, they will destroy everything. We are all that stands between this world and annihilation. I fought at his side once, shortly after my conversion. Before the battle, he was everything a general should be. A charismatic leader with a brilliant strategic mind. And when the fighting began, he led his troops from the front and cut through the enemy like a scythe through stalks. Blows and arrows rained down on him, and before long, his face was a mask of blood, but he did not fall. He did not even falter. When we won the day, Ketherick's armor was bent and shattered, but his flesh was unmarked. I have lived long enough to know that few things are impossible in this world. Oh, Ketherick's power is a rare thing, though. I have never seen its like. The necromancer Balthazar is Ketherick's chief advisor. One who has mastery over the dead may well be able to help the living cheat it. He is usually in his laboratory, elbow deep in offal, or clinging to his master's side. If he left Moonrise, his mission must be urgent. We should ransack his chambers and see what secrets he keeps for the great general.
Speak your mind. I'm listening. Don't say a word. Just listen. A parasite grips my mind. The shadows curse me. But I am gnawed by an even greater torment. You. My thoughts are hallowed ground. Yet you've crawled your way in. Uninvited. I'm obsessed by the ground under your feet and the wind over your head. I see your face just before I sleep and after I wake. I ask myself, are you worthy, Shakvonastu? There is only one way for you to prove it. A fine sentiment, but I require more. We fight. I test you in battle. Dance with me. Bleed with me. Bruise me so that you might possess me.
Ah! let's get this over with. At the ready. You can take me on. Don't waste a step. With haste.
Wound me, scar me.
Lazel's touch is unusually gentle. Her fingers lightly graze your bruises and wipe away your sweat.
No more. I can't bear it. I've torn flesh from monsters and men. I've laughed as they suffered, hurt you. I don't want to hurt you. I want to protect you. For you to protect me. I am yours. Say the words.
Go ahead. I'm listening.
With pleasure. Lead on.
Need something? Darling, I thought you'd never ask. Lead on.
Speak your mind. I'm listening. It is done.
My drink, you know.
I know, Astarion. You prefer blood.
Well, yes. It was a joke.
I know that too. It just wasn't funny.